Hello, everyone, and welcome inside the CIF. I'm Richard Thiemann here with another set of home and away opponents for another team competing in the 2021 CIF season. Up next, the Omaha Beef. All right, fans, here with me to go over the Omaha Beef home and away opponents, Coach Marvin Jones. Welcome, Coach. How are you?
Oh, I'm awesome, man. Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely, Coach. We're just a couple of days away from the revised schedule release. We only have you and one more team left to kind of have this sneak peek. So the obvious question, first and foremost, what do you think of your home and away opponents?
Well, I think our home and away opponents, I think it's great. I think, you know, one of the biggest things for us is Sioux City, you know, being right up the pike off of the 29 rivalry. So that's always been a long time, big time rivalry. And obviously the last time we played them in 2019, we beat them to jump into the playoffs and they didn't. So that's kind of one of our biggest key matchups.
Yeah, Coach Strobing mentioned that he was looking forward to facing you guys. You will get them. They're your first home game of the season, and then you have them twice on the road. So the rivalry will continue. You guys have any kind of trash talk going back and forth?
Oh, no. One thing about us in this league, we get along well. I think we just mainly, you know, let our players, you know, do all the talking. I think that's kind of the way it's been, and I think that's always the best way. Nothing's personal. We're just here trying to, you know, win some games and continue to keep an exciting rivalry, you know, alive. And I think just playing against a team like that, obviously the last time just made it more special because of the rivalry and getting to the playoffs with the win.
And for the fans watching at home, your guys' home and away opponents are: at home, you'll take on Sioux City, Wichita, Wyoming, Salina, and Oklahoma. And away, you will travel to Salina, Sioux City, Wyoming, Oklahoma, and Sioux City. Your guys' first official CIF contest will be on the road against Salina. How do you feel about going into regular season competition on the road?
I think it's always great to be able to go into a hostile environment the first time. Last time we were there, obviously have a little sour taste in our mouth playing the division championship up there. You know, that was kind of a tough year. So I'm anxious to, you know, get back on the field and go up against them. I think that, you know, Coach Arad is a great coach, known him for a long time, and he does what he does well. And, you know, as an organization for us, I mean, it's something that, you know, we have to come out with some victories in this, because last time we played them, I mean, we they swept us that season, 3 games. So, you know, that's still a tough pill to swallow. But, I mean, I think, you know, just going up and around, I know he's going to do a great job and being able to recruit some great players. So, I expect that. I mean, that's, you know, that was our last biggest opponent we had to play. And, you know, we just have to beat them. We have to find ways to win on the road. That's going to be the main thing for us.
Now, with no 2020 season and kind of a different offseason and now a revised schedule, you guys only play the new expansion team, the Wyoming Mustangs, twice, both home and away. But what kind of challenge does playing an expansion team in general present to you guys?
Well, it poses a lot of challenges because you don't know any of the players. You don't know the coaching style of the head coach. I mean, Keith Russ, I mean, I know he was kind of an outdoor coach, and now he's jumping indoor. So you have no clue what they're going to do initially, you know, unless they play some type of preseason game. But most teams are going to do what I do in preseason. I'm just going to be so vanilla, you know, on what we call and what we play that you're really not going to be able to pick up on it. And I think that that's what's important for us, is because the simple fact that, you know, going into Salina in the first game of the season, which is going to be our top opponent, this is a team you're going to have to beat at the end of the year if you want to get to the playoff. So you got to be careful what you put out there and what you show too early and let them prepare for it. So kind of makes it kind of tough, but you got to be able to mix up some things. But kind of getting back to Wyoming, just knowing not what a head coach is, you know, his playbook, any of those type of stuff, you know, it kind of makes it tough a lot of times. But, you know, one of the things I believe in is, you know, believe in my coaching style. I believe how I coach my players, and I try to prepare them. You know, when I get to training camp, I throw everything at them. I give them everything what we don't even run. I just tell my offensive coordinator, you know what, just run everything you can possibly run so we can get adjustments and get a look at it, get it on film, and then we'll dissect it. And we'll prepare for anything that comes.
A lot of coaches I've talked to are very excited about playing you guys, not just because they're the Omaha Beef and, you know, one of the longest tenured teams in the indoor football world, but also because you are the head coach and this will be your first official full season as head coach. How do you feel about that with these guys being excited to take you on?
Well, it's great. I think, you know, I always look at myself for who I play and how I prepare against the team. I mean, I look at guys like Haran, or, you know, that's a championship coaches, you know, coach and, you know, the IFL played on a bigger level, upper level, and what he has done. I like where I match up against these guys. My goal is to beat these guys because that at least let me get some type of moral satisfaction that, you know, that I'm doing well, I'm coaching well. So we all know each other in this league, and we know what the capabilities of our coaches are. And one of the greatest things I think what's going on, what I noticed with all these coaches, is that they're all good recruiters. They're able to bring talent in. I mean, Sioux City's going to be a totally different team, but I mean, they're going to have some talent. Every team in this league is going to be able to have some talent, you know, just simply by what's going on. I mean, indoors become a lot more popular now, obviously after COVID, and guys looking for ways to get film, and you know, the indoor arena has kind of arrived, and, you know, I put out there more guys knowing they need this kind of path to get there. So the talent is going to be better, and we're all good recruiters, and that's the thing. So whatever you've seen in the offseason, these guys signing, I mean, it could be a, you know, 10 guys could not be there, and they could have 10 more guys. So it's just exciting against playing with them. And I mean, like I said, when I'm offseason, when I'm recruiting, I look at who I'm playing against, and I got to know the type of players that are on these other teams that I need players to kind of counter that, or to be better at, or that I feel like can stop these players that they have on these other teams.
Absolutely. One of the other hot topics has been bye weeks and where they are in the season for each team. Now, you guys don't see action the first official week, and then you have a bye week shortly after that. So how do you plan on using those first couple of bye weeks early in the season?
Well, the way I've traditionally used it, I just try to get as many practices as I can. I mean, it gives you some advantage because you got more time to prepare. You're not getting that game action that you obviously need if you have, especially for the young and new players. But it does give you an opportunity to cycle through some players, see what some players got, bring in some players, kind of get a bead on some of the other teams on what they have and what you need to prepare for. You know, but it's just how you use it. I use it to just get as much practice as I can in and see what else is out there as players. It gives me opportunity to bring some new players in if I need them. So that's what I use it for. it's gonna be important, but it's hard because, you know, when you get into these long seasons, you get these four or five game stretches sometimes. I mean, or you get certain type of injuries, the guys nicked up and you want to rest them. I mean, that's where they're really more useful, not at the beginning when guys should be, you know, coming into camp, you know, in shape somewhat. So I just, you know, hope we can kind of get around to, you know, our bye weeks fit to where we need them as far as when our rest period. So.
Sounds like a plan to me. So you look at your home and away opponents. Is there a particular matchup that grabs your attention?
All of them. I think one of the hardest things has always been a football coach is that you don't know how you're going to respond. I mean, I got a team of guys that obviously I started the first week, you know, with 2020. Obviously, we didn't get into the season on that, but I never had them in a real game situation. So I really don't know how they're going to respond. I just know that I put a bunch of good guys together with great attitudes. They're going to work hard. I know that much, but a majority of my team has not been in that arena environment. So, but I think all these matchups are going to be very competitive from what I've seen as far as rosters. Obviously the main thing is going to be how are you able to coach these guys up? In my experience in 5 years of being around this game is that, you know, when you have these new players, man, it takes them some time on average, maybe 4 to 6 weeks generally sometime before they really, really get the hang of. This will probably be, you know, from my eyes, is the most competitive year even more competitive in 2019 right now because of the simple fact that all these coaches can recruit. And there's way more talent out there than teams able to play on. So it's not hard to, you know, kind of get guys that are really wanting to play and adjusted to this game. So, I mean, this game has really grown in popularity. I'm looking forward to all these matchups. And hopefully I can win more than I lose. You know, that's kind of my goal in football is win more than I lose.
Yeah, that is the goal, and it looks like a great field of competition going into the 2021 season. Once again, the big revised schedule release Thursday, February 18th. And Coach, thank you so much for your time. It's always fun to chat with you and talk a little CIF football.
I appreciate it. Thanks. Have a great evening. Let's go Beef, baby. Beef.
He is Coach Marvin Jones of the Omaha Beef. You have a great night, Coach. And one more big thank you to Coach Jones for joining me today to go over the Beef's home and away opponents. Remember, we only have one more team left to get a sneak peek at their home and away opponents before the big revised schedule release Thursday, February 18th. So remember to check back tomorrow at noon for the last team, the Wichita Force. Until then, I'm Richard Thiemann, and this is Inside the CIF.